Hi, I'm Dr. Stephen Lester. I'm one of the radiation oncologists here at Central Florida Cancer Care Center in the metropolitan Orlando area. Today we're discussing prostate cancer prevention. We get a lot of questions about that, especially from family members when they come in and dad has been diagnosed with prostate cancer. Unfortunately, we don't have a pill we can give you to prevent prostate cancer. There have been several studies that have looked at some of the medications that are used for enlarged prostates to see if they will reduce the risk of prostate cancer, and it hasn't been proven to be effective enough. I think when one deals with prostate cancer prevention, what we really would like to do at this point in time, since we can't prevent it, is to prevent high-risk prostate cancer. That is the more aggressive prostate cancer. And there is some data that if there are certain lifestyle modifications and dietary modifications, we may be able to accomplish that. This is based on looking at other cultures who then move to our country and change their diet, eat a higher fat diet, get less soybean in their diet. They seem to have more aggressive prostate cancer. So a lot of what you would consider a heart healthy diet is also good for reducing the risk at high risk prostate cancer. That's the best we can do at this time. So we encourage patients to follow a low saturated fat diet. We like them to incorporate some omega-3s into their diet, eating fish. We would say eating more tomatoes is beneficial because of the lycopene. Eating some soybean proteins are important. There's some data, maybe drinking some fresh brewed tea every day may help. Now, when patients hear this, they always go, how much? And we really don't know how much. The idea is just to work it into your diet. If you enjoy the food product, make sure you eat it. If you don't, you can try some different supplements to try to get the more beneficial proteins out of soybean. Another one that probably helps is losing weight. We've noticed that patients with higher body mass index seem to have more prostate cancer when they have their prostates removed. So the idea here is to reduce your weight, and that may help by reducing fats in the diet and getting better blood sugar control. There's some data that tighter blood sugar control may benefit patients with prostate cancer. Another one that may or may not affect prostate cancer, but we see is a lot of our patients have lower vitamin D levels. And we think it's important to get your vitamin D level checked and increase vitamin D in your diet or through supplements. If you take it through supplements, make sure you take it with a meal as it doesn't absorb well on an empty stomach. Exercise helps, just reducing stress. And there is some data potentially that patients with sleep apnea have more cancers. And we encourage our patients who have sleep apnea to use their CPAP.